It feels good in my heart, in my soul, when you're right here beside me. I don't ever want this day to end. We can watch the waves, have a coke, and just sit here beside me. I take a little of my heart again, so we can feel forever, yeah, feel together, be real together, and no one can.
Hello and warm welcome to another exciting edition of Coca-Cola at 30, where we are celebrating a tournament that started in 1989, churning out stars, and also some schools are winning it for a record four times. This week we are taking a different approach. We are going to be speaking to the NASH president, that's Johnson Maduku, just talking about the importance of this tournament in terms of grassroots football development. But he's not just the head in charge of football in Zimbabwe, he's also the headmaster at Pamushana. They've won it before, and this year they say they are going to win it again after a long time. And then we're going to shift base and talk to one of the legends of COPPA. The legend is none other than Harlington Shereni. He's played for the Warriors, played for Dynamos, but also played for Nantes, that's in France. We're also going to be tracing his roots back in Hippo Valley, and coincidentally we're also going to be at Hippo Valley, known for sugarcane production, but also known for producing a number of stars, one of them Harlington Shereni. But we're going to be talking about the school. They've won it four times, and they are saying they are going to be the first school that will win it for a record five times. And our first port of call is going to be at Pamushana, where we are going to be speaking to Johnson Maduku, the NASH head.
With every fading sunset, we see. As the club continues to tick towards the 2018 Copa Coca-Cola Finals, the significance of the Under-15 Schools Football Flagship Tournament continues to come under the spotlight, given its massive contribution in nurturing talent that has gone on to represent the country. Peter Ndlovu, Benjamin Konjera, Knowledge Musonan, Kama Biliard, and Kaitano Tembo are among a long list of footballers to make a mark on the football arena, having passed through the Copa Coca-Cola tournament. With 2018 being a year in which Coca-Cola are celebrating the 30th anniversary of the biggest schools football competition, National Association for Secondary School Heads President Johnson Maduku remains conscious of the critical role Coca-Cola have played in the development of Zimbabwean football.
Coca-Cola has played a very, very pivotal role, a very big role, which I think we have to applaud, even as a nation, not only as us, as NASH, as schools, but as a nation, we have to recognize and the great role they have played.
While celebrating the long-lasting partnership with Coca-Cola, the NASH president, who is also the headmaster of Pamushana High School, is hoping his school will excel at the 2018 competition. A visit to the school's training ground outlined a deep desire to excel at this year's Copa Coca-Cola tournament, with players optimistic of landing the coveted prize.
We really promise you, we are going to take the trophy.
I think we shall win because we are training very hard.
We are going to win the Coca-Cola tournament because we are training very hard.
Winning is not a new phenomenon for Pamushana, who powered to glory in the 2007 tournament held in Mashonga Province. As the school endeavors to again come up with a winning formula, Pamushana head coach Bernard Matenga says key to securing another title are thorough preparations.
The secret is actually preparation, hard work. We train every day. We deal with the junior policy. Look at here, we are having three teams, 415. So we have three teams now. You see there's one team that is out, there are two teams there. One which lost there will go out, the next team will get in. So we have three strong teams for under 15 that we are working with.
Matenga is however aware of the battles that lie ahead with Deure, Gutu and Hippo Valley among schools that will offer stiff competition at the provincial finals.
Everybody just believes we cannot lose to Pamushana. It used to be Pamushana for some time. Now they are saying, no, it must not be you alone. We are also there.
It's very tough here in Mashingo. You know, when we go for these competitions, it's like that's the national finals in Mashingo. But there are big guys here. You know, we talk of Hippo Valley down there. It's not only Hippo Valley. The other schools which are there, they're doing very well in the low field. And you talk about Pamshana Deure and the other guys in Mashingo, Christian, you talk about Father School, they're doing very well in Mashingo. So it's very tough.
While the main focus will be on claiming the 2018 Copa title, Pamshana High School Sportsmaster John Tumbare gains gratification from the talent that has passed through the school.
The likes of Wana Atuo Mkandi, Wana Gilroy, Wana Simba Nivi, like you mentioned, Wana Tafaza Mawori, Wana Gabriel Nyoni. It's really a pleasure. Kana tinge chwa wana wachi play Mulegi. And even at times, if you attempted to be business, something else, as knowing that a match in which one of your former students is featuring, is not a lot of joy.
Having asserted themselves as a school renowned for football prowess, Pamshana High School's headmaster says creating a balance between sport and academic excellence is the hallmark of the school.
Whilst we are doing very well in sports, in soccer, we are also doing very well in academic work. So you find out that even those players you think they are sort of average or slightly below average, when they come to this place, they'll do very well.
As schools battle for a place at the 2018 national finals, there is hope that more clubs will tap into the talent that will be on display in Rishavane when schools line up to compete in Zimbabwe's biggest football competition, the Copa Coca-Cola tournament.
Well, it's always important to keep the eyes on the ball when it comes to football. Pamshana, we hope that they will keep their eye not only on the ball but also on the prize money. They want to win it again. But it's interesting to see that in Mashingo. They say that once you win in Mashingo, you're most probably likely to win it at the national finals. There's a certain rivalry that illuminates this great province. There's two-time champions Deure. There's also Hippo Valley, we've won it for four times. Pamshana have won it. Good to also want to win it in the girls' category. You also talk of Chijigama Kona. What a province that is rich in terms of football. You're watching Copa Coca-Cola at 30.
So we can feel wherever you feel. Together be real, together and no one can.
Welcome back. You're still watching Copa Coca-Cola at 30. And this is a segment where we talk to the stars that were part of the history of this tournament. Remember, we're celebrating 30 years. And one of the rare stars that came out of this tournament is Harlington Shereni. He was part of Hippo Valley. He also played for the national team. And besides that, he played for Dynamos, Caps United, and Air Zimbabwe Jets. But he went on to play in Europe, Switzerland, and in France. And we have taken him back to his school. That's a Hippo Valley, Harlington Shereni. It's good to have you, man. And thanks for having us at this special place where all the memories are coming from. And talking about the memories, what are some of the memories that evoked when you come to this place?
Hey, you know, our house is less than 2 kilometers from here. And this is where I grew up. This is what made my name. This is the school, the primary school there, the community, and the whole company that made who I am today. And brings a lot of good memories. It brings a lot of good things that happened here. And I'm glad I got this opportunity from Coca-Cola to come back here, be at the school where it all started, be at the school where we won Coca-Cola two times, and also after that they won again two times. And this is one of the best memories that I can get from these guys. And I'm very, very grateful to Coca-Cola because also they gave me an opportunity. You know, this is an opportunity where I thank both the sponsors, I thank both Hippo Valley, the community, the company, which made everything happen for us.
And Harlington, when you talk of that team, you were the captain when you won it
for 2 years in succession, but you're the standout guy, but you must have played alongside some special players. What were those players that you played alongside with, and what can you tell us about how special that team was?
In that team, I had players that were very talented, that I thought they would play in Europe. I know, I thought these players would play even national team. It's very unfortunate that we're situated in a province where we didn't have much exposure, but our football was great. We had a very good junior police, and that helped us. We had Kevin Masimbe, who went to play in Zisco Steel. We had players like Tamir Epi, who is the coach of ZPC. They came from this school. We have got so many guys that came from this school that were produced by this school, and also because of Copa Coca-Cola, they got this opportunity to go and play in the Premier League.
And talking about this tournament, I know it's a special tournament, but for you as an individual, how important was it to launch your career? You've been everywhere, almost everywhere in the world.
We were good when Masingo, when Chirezi, we were in Ipoh Valley. We were good, but nobody would see how we were playing if it wasn't for the national finals that we went and played and won. So Coca-Cola, it's very important because it took me to another level. It took me to a national stage where everybody could see me. And that also helped me go to Caps United from school, then from there Jets and Dynamos, and to the national team.
You played as an under 20 when you won it for two consecutive years, but now it has shifted to under 15. How important do you think is that shift coming down to under 15?
I think it's a good move because if we look at the structures of our nation at the moment, we're not really putting much effort into junior development. Under 20, I'm pretty sure they are already mature enough to play in the first teams in Premier League. But we need to concentrate on under 15 and maybe under 13, because that's where they have to get the basics, that's where they have to know about soccer. And I'm happy that they moved to under 15, which is also very good for the nation as a whole.
And then let's shift to the province, Shereni. When you speak of Masingo, names come to the mind, Ipoh Valley, you're talking of Pamshana, you're talking of Deure. What is it that is so special about this province? And the competition is so tough.
I think the competition here is very tough. Each school wants to win, each school wants to represent, and they've seen it. I think they've seen it from what has come out of this, most schools. We've got Tawiamre, who came out of Gokomere. We've got Lloyd Tlatla also, who came out from Masingo province. So this inspires the youngsters that are there now. And I think they also want to show the rest of Zimbabwe that, you know, we in Masingo must be recognized as a power in sport.
The Girl Child are part of the tournament since 2011. What do you think about the inclusion?
This is very important. If we look at our girls, they're already coming. They went to the Olympics. They competed there. And we need a feeder to the national team. We need to tell also the girls that they can also play soccer and be as competitive as boys. So this initiative by Coca-Cola, it came at the right time, and it's also good to show the girls that we don't only consider boys to play soccer. We don't only look at the glory of boys. We want also you guys to showcase your talent and to show the world that you, as a girl child, you can do it as well.
And Arlington, just in your background, there are some youngsters ball juggling and preparing for this year's tournament. What words of inspiration do you have for these young boys as they enter into Copa 30?
This is something big. It's 30th anniversary, and we've done it four times. What I want to tell these boys is that we only need one more trophy to make it five and be the first ones to reach five trophies. So I think this is big, this is massive, and we really need it. And I hope the boys are inspired to emulate what we did. Maybe we win it 2 years in a row, and I hope they can do that. And me coming here and telling them, I think they can also see the importance of this CS edition.
Harlington, you also went on to captain your team in France, but the background that comes back to Ipoh Valley. You also captain for the team. We saw your name on the board there. Was it valuable in terms of having that background as a captain when you went on to lead on the international scene?
You know, when you are given responsibility from the time you are at school, it shows that you are mature enough to lead the people. And I think that comes also from the school, how they groom you, the community, how they look after you. So I'm happy that I was captain and I led by example, although the last year we couldn't make it to the national finals. But I think it taught me a lot and helped me become the captain in a foreign country, especially in Europe. It's something that I'm very proud of, and it shows that those people had so much respect for our talent coming from Zimbabwe.
You played so many games, Arlington, at school level, national team, but we want to zero in on one special game that you played when you're playing for Hippo Valley. What is that game?
The game that I really, it's a game that I got disappointed. It's a game that we lost to Zilikazi in the semifinals in Bulawayo. We lost to Peter and Love Steam, which went on to win against Sekou High. And I think that time, the reason why I remember that game is because of the stars that it produced. It produced one of the best one of the greatest players ever to play for Zimbabwe, was Peter and Love. And I'm happy that at that stage we could compete together. We could even say, no, I think we can go further. And I'm happy that that game made me know these big names, and it helped also our school to say, okay, if we are competing with such players, I think we can also do better.
Well, Arlington, thanks very much, man. A lot of sugar cane around, a lot of grass. This must be a green community. We're talking there to a special man, Arlington Chereni. He came from this community, Hippo Valley, this particular school, and he's one of the stars that played in the Copa Coca-Cola. We are celebrating 30 years of a great tournament. This is Copa Coca-Cola at 30.
So we can feel forever, you feel together, be real together, and no one cares. It feels good in my heart, in my soul, when you're right here beside me.
Well, we're staying in Hippo Valley, but not talking to Chereni this time, but talking about his school. The name Hippo Valley, did you know that the area has the largest population in terms of hippos? But we're also talking about sugarcane. It's the hub of sugarcane production in Zimbabwe. We're talking of Hippo Valley. We're also talking of Triangle. It's the same area where, when you talk about sugarcane production, you cannot talk about it without referring to Hippo Valley. But we are football people, and we're talking about football. This is a school that has won it for a record 4 times, alongside Muzilikazi and of course Chechu. They say they want to win it for 5 times. They want to be the first boys school to win it for 5 times. Shijigamakone have already done it in the girls category. But we're at their school, at their training ground. Let's hear what they had to say, the coach and also the players.
Hippo Valley derives its name from having a large population of hippopotamus, with large tracts of sugarcane plantations a constant feature of Chiredzi. In the heart of Chiredzi is Hippo Valley High School, an institution renowned for excellence on the football pitch. Hippo Valley is among just 3 schools to have won the Copa Coca-Cola title for a record 4 times. And when looking back to past glory on the football pitch, one of the school's longest-serving members, Daniel Gwashava, has fond memories of the institution's past glory.
During those days, it was quite surprising for a small sugar community school to win those cups. And winning a national Coca-Cola Cup is not easy. You play so many games, from zonal level to national level, and each time you meet so many hurdles. So when we first won it in 1990, it was we hosted it here, and then we had our own great hero, Arlington Chereni, Kevin Masimbe, and his brother, who was known as Tiko. These played wonderful soccer, And then we have got a lecturer by the name of Absalom Joyson, who scored the only goal in the final versus Prince Edward. Then we went to Kadoma in 1991, where we retained the cup, beating Seke 2 in the final, 1-0, Kevin Masimbo scoring again. Ellington Sheeran was in the team. We defeated the great players like Engel Debet, Dina, Othin Juaye. Then there's this one, Lloyd Chitembwe, the coach of Cape United.
Also reflecting on past successes in the Copa Coca-Cola tournament is Ipo Valley High Deputy Headmaster Constance Singo, who outlines the positive image that was brought about by being four-time champions in the school's football extravaganza.
It is quite good for us to be on the picture because we've won it and we hope to do it again in the near future.
With an array of stars being part of Ipo Valley's success, Daniel Gwashara is gratified to have gone through the experience of witnessing several former students grow to become professional footballers.
I'm happy. I've seen it all. Whenever I see Sharon's name written in the newspapers or magazines, I would always remind my friends that I taught this boy. He came here from our school. Yeah, because Ellington became a star with Dynamos, playing in the 1998 CAF Champions League final. And he's our product, right from this school. So we feel very grateful and proud of that.
It has been over a decade since Ipo Valley last won the Copa Coca-Cola title, with their last victory coming in 1997. With so many years having passed, the Ipo Valley under 15 side is hoping to rekindle moments of glory by landing the prestigious Copa Coca-Cola title in 2018.
This year we expect to win because we've started quite well grooming from the juniors so that they can be able to proceed to the nationals.
One of the star players is Michael Lungu, who believes Ipo Valley have what it takes to power to glory at the provincial finals and represent the province with distinction in Rishavane.
Isusu tukutrena kuti tikwanise kuita zvekuti chikoro chedu chisumukire pane zvese zvatoita saka tinotrena every day tinoita ma skills akasiyana siyana kuti tichigadzirirawo mamwe ma teams isusu tiri vanhu vadiki saka tingatiitira kuti tikasangana nevanhu vakati kurei tinokwanisa kudi kuzotambawo bhora rakanaka.
The school may look back at a glorious past, but Sean Stolle, a key player in the Ipo Valley team, says the current crop is eager to engrave their names in the history books.
As far as football is concerned, tiri vanhu vanoridawo bhora and tiri kuda kufaita kuti tiribudise kuti vamwe vambozvionawo kuti hazviri kuipo vhali zvakanaka saka tinoshuvira kuti kumanishi tichange tichiwanikwa ikoko.
With Mashingo province providing arguably the most difficult road to the national finals, Ipo Valley High players say a deep sense of belief in winning this year's title stems from the hard work being put into preparing for the Copa Coca-Cola competition.
To train every day in at 2 o'clock, tava lunch, saka to gona to win, to win, to da to buda o paka wanda wanda. He awe ukubero baruku Ipo Valley wa wano win.
To itangwe maskills angu siyana siyana. To ishi train wane makochi edu. Mugadziro dzangu siyana siyana ole.
In attempts to inspire the 2018 Copa Coca-Cola squad, one of Ipo Valley's most decorated success stories, Hallington Shereni, took time to give a pep talk to the under-15 side that will do battle at this year's tournament. Shereni's name is engraved at the administration block, having captained Ipo Valley in 1993 and 1994. Despite various challenges that may confront their endeavor to win a fifth title, Ipo Valley is hoping to once again put their name in the history books by becoming the first school to win the Copa Coca-Cola title for a record 5 times.
Well, interesting stuff. We're down in Ipo Valley. We've been to several areas. We've been to Mzingwane, that's in Esigodini. We've been to Bulawayo, where we have spoken to those that were at Mzilikazi. We are going around the country celebrating some of the schools that won Copa Coca-Cola. Remember, we are celebrating 30 years of Copa Coca-Cola. It all started in 1989, and another edition is coming up this year in Zishawane. But before we get to Zishawane, we might just be in your area. So make sure that when it's the provincials, or rather the districts, you're also performing well so that you're part of this celebration. This is Copa Coca-Cola 30.
Make it easier to sing, yeah.